Something that happened 50 years ago, or is there something more to be learned from what we see around us at the library today?
Right. Well, we conceived this as not an homage, because obviously San Francisco was going to do this in a big way. Lots of institutions were going to have exhibits, and institutions with a lot more resources than the library does. But the library has archives, so we have the papers of, you know, like the mayor, the man who was mayor at the time, the first home for runaway kids, lots of documents from newspapers, and I just kept running into treasures. So the idea was to make that all come together in a story for people, like a narrative in this room that's, you know, you can do it in 15 or 20 minutes to get an idea of what it really was and the context, what San Francisco, you know, was like at the time. Because all of San Francisco wasn't the Haight-Ashbury. So we start with the scene, what was there before, because we tend, I think often, whatever's there when we're alive is what was always there. But the Haight-Ashbury was, it got this infiltration of young people because there were all these flats and, you know, apartments that could be divided up, and it was not a great neighborhood. And before that, it was a black neighborhood, and before that, it was, you know, way long ago, obviously, it was Indians. So we wanted to kind of put this in a little bit of context, and San Francisco itself was quite a conservative. This was one of the surprises to me. I think one of the quotes says it was run by Irish cops. And if you look at some of the, you know, the photos of other neighborhoods in San Francisco, it's all the, you know, the big hair and the men in suits or with little, you know, short hair and glasses, and all the women are wearing dresses, and it, I mean, it looks like the old country basically to us. That was one of the surprises to me, was that San Francisco wasn't this liberal bastion that we, you know, we think of it today.